Hello and welcome to WordPress Tutorials. In today's video, I'll show you how to build a custom blog page for your new site just like this, or even better, with Elementor free and a free plugin called Premium Add-ons for Elementor. So if you do not have the Premium plugin add-on, come to Plugins, click on Add New. Then search for Premium Add-ons for Elementor. Press Enter. And this is the plugin. You have to install and activate this plugin. Now you have to build a new page. Click on Pages, Add New, and name your page, for example, Blogs or News. I'll name it as News. Choose the template of your choice. For example, I'm choosing Elementor Full Width, and click on Publish. Now click on Edit with Elementor. Now click a new row. You can even add a sidebar, but I will add a plain row, just like my existing news page, which is this one. It's a single column layout, and in the single column, click on Add, scroll down to the Premium Add-on section, this one, and choose Posts, Premium Blog, maybe this one, and the blogs are there. These blogs are already added to my WordPress dashboard. If you open the dashboard, then you can see some posts added to your website, but if there are no posts, then you can add them in Posts. Click on All Posts. Here I have 42 blog posts, and I want them to be shown on my news page. So this is how it will look like. It will automatically grab all the news page. You can add pagination, and you can add category filter as well, just like my existing page, this one. These are the categories. If I click on this category, all the blog posts from this category will be loaded, and if I click on news, then all the news will be loaded within this page. So for now, I only have the blog post, the latest post on this page. Let me add a title and a banner like this. Open, add a new row, click on Add New row. But for the row setting, click Full Width and then click Stretched. So it will take a full width of the page. Now I'll add an image. Click on Image and choose the picture. I'll choose the beetle picture as a background. Insert Media, or let's just add this in a background. So I'll delete this section, and in the column, click on Style, click on Background, and choose the picture here. Okay, now choose the attachment as default. Position will be center, and repeat, no repeat. Attachment or size is equal to cover. Okay, now add some margins padding to the top and bottom. Actually, all sides, and it will cover the whole section. Okay, now if you want to add your title here, grab the title, latest news, change color, and click on this section settings again. Scroll down to the style and to the background overlay. Click on classic and choose color black, and choose the opacity to maintain the background visibility. So here is the best for this one. Okay, now click on this section and click on this element. Okay, skin will be modern. You can change the skin, which means the design will be changed completely if you choose a different design. So this is how the title and the content are overlapping the image in this design. Okay, for the featured image, let's choose a smaller version of the picture, so all the pictures are the same size. If they have this size, then it's okay. If not, then let's choose another size. Okay, now all the pictures are the same size, but these are a little bit distorted. So I'll suggest the size which you already have. If you upload larger than 300 by 300 size, then they must have this 300 by 300. So it's a perfect square. Okay, now the featured image. Let's adjust the height of the picture. Okay, cover is the best. And this is the overlay effect, which is a glass effect. Okay, now let's add a pagination here. You can change from two columns to three columns as well. And maybe that will be a better option because the size of the thumbnail is smaller, and this will look much better. So if the posts are three posts per row, then let's just increase the number to 9, so we have three columns and three rows on each page. Okay, now let's come to the query section. The query means that which post type you want to do for this page. So I'll choose the journal post because my news are in the post section. So if you have WooCommerce products or my templates, pop-ups, Elementor header, footer, any other post type, you can choose that, but I'll use this for the posts. Match categories, category filter. You can add category filters here, so these posts will only be shown from this specific category. But I'll not choose a specific category because I'll choose these types of filters. I'll use these filters on the top, so I'll add them later. Okay, now the query will get from post, and all these settings will be as it is. Featured image, display option. The title will be H2. You can change it to H3 or H1. This tag, but I'll keep it H2. The row spacing, you can increase the space between each row. You can see this is 50px now, but I'll leave it as 10 or 11 because the row and the column space must be same. It was 5. Okay, column spacing, you can also change row and column spacing both. Alignment will be left align, post option. Now we have this post excerpt. We have this post excerpt, which is this much. Sorry for this. Which is this much. You can change it from ...22 characters to 50 characters, so it will show longer post content on each box, but 22 is best for this size. You can also add remove the author meta. For example, this is the author name, so you can hide it and it will not show the author name, the data, the category, this one, as well as the comments. So I'll keep all of these on. You can also show tags from each post, but maybe I do not have tags for most of these posts, so I'll hide this. Okay, now load more posts on scroll. This means it will be infinitely load all the posts when you scroll down the page. So I do not want this for my page, but you can also use this one. Let me update the page and let me show you what does this mean. Let's see the preview. Okay, latest news, the banner, and if we scroll down, and you can see that there is no pagination and no on scroll loading. But if you turn this on, load more, and click on update. Now if you come here and scroll down to the end, then it will load more posts until you reach the end. So I'll not use this. I'll show you how to use pagination. So turn this off, and I'll also add the filters. If you turn this tab on, then you can see the categories are now as used as filters. If you choose this category, then all these posts will be from this category. Similar for these two. Okay, now scroll down to the pagination. The carousel is a slider. If you turn this on, then these posts will be in the shape of a carousel slider. Turn this on, and you can choose auto play off or on. You can show slides to show on single slide, center mode, slide spacing, and navigation. If you check this now, then there is a slider with arrows. So all these posts will be shown in the carousel. I'll turn this on because I need the posts per page, just like these. Okay, now for the pagination, turn pagination on, and you will see that there is a pagination on the bottom of this page. So click on update, and let's see on the front end how it looks like. Refresh the page. Now you can see there are the categories. If I click on any other category, then these posts will be loaded from this category. Similarly, the Beatles band, the news, and if you scroll down to the bottom, then you can see that there is a pagination. So if we click the page number 3, then it will load all the contents from page number 3. So this is how you can build a new blog post for your WordPress website. But now the main problem is that when you click on the blogs, your blogs must be loaded. So you must come to the dashboard, click on settings, and in the reading page you must have to choose your news page, which is this one, and click on save changes. Now your default news page will be this one. So in the menu, I'll also assign this page. Come to the menu. Appearance, click on menus. And in the news, first of all, add this new news page. This one to the menu and replace this one. Remove the old and update the menu. Now if we refresh our page, and if you come here, then you can see that this is the news page which we just created. Now we have to choose this page as our default post page. Or if you made a custom page, then you must choose another page for that, so your design will be shown on this page. Let's choose another page, and if you refresh this news to page, then you can see that the banner and all your settings are there on this page. So this was all for today's video. Please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to our channel so you won't miss our future updates. Thank you.